Well, it's just overwhelming to see, no? If only the typhoon victims can actually see what's happening here, that will really turn their mourning into dancing, you know? And I'm sure you guys out there are also trying your best to just connect with the goodness in everyone and turn this whole tragedy into our moment in history of the world, no? And Yolanda made history by being the strongest typhoon ever to be recorded in history. So, and it ushered the Filipino into the consciousness of the global community. They're saying now, they're quoting the word bayanihan. They're looking at the resiliency of our people. And this is a moment of greatness for the Filipino. And if I really would like you to see this. This is a sight to behold. Thousands of volunteers, young, old, you know, are helping one another, trying to pack food packs. And then you see this very long bayanihan line towards the container that will bring the food packs to Ormoc. And right now, just to give you a short update, we are currently establishing base in Tacloban, and a group from Bukidnon will man that base. There are about 175 volunteers from Bukidnon who will stay 24/7 for the next 2 weeks in Tacloban. And then a team from Kalbayog will go to Burongan, that is in Samar. I suggest you look at the map so you can follow what I'm talking about. We will set up a base in Burongan to serve Eastern Samar. And of course, in Ormoc and the surrounding Leyte provinces. But while we are looking at Leyte, Tacloban, and Samar, our groups in Iloilo are already serving most of Panay. Panay was also hard hit by Typhoon Yolanda or Haiyan. And then our group in Cebu is serving North Cebu. So you see, what you see Gawad Kalinga today, it is really made up of different organizations now, no? Just linking arms with one another in the true spirit of solidarity in bayanihan. So you have ships that are offered for free, transportation of our goods. You have different organizations. So Gawad Kalinga has become that spirit, has become that platform of convergence. GK today is no longer just our organization, but it is a convergence of many, many organizations just wanting to reconnect to the motherland, wanting to do something and become relevant to this very, very important moment in the history of the world. No? And the Philippines is at the heart of that. Climate change issue and what to do with it, governance, everything. We are, you know, the spotlight of the global communities upon the Philippines. And kayo naman dyan sa Canada o sa US o sa Australia, bring that light, no? Be that light for our brethren here. And sabi ko nga, no, and narinig ko and alam nyo itong kantang ito, and allow me to speak in Tagalog this time and communicate to the Filipinos, no? Sabi nga, lahat tayo may pananagutan, no? Walang sino man sa atin na ay nabubuhay para sa sarili lamang, walang namamatay para sa sarili lamang, lahat tayo ay may pananagutan. Itong lahat na gawain ng Walang Iwanan, yung pagdadala ng relief, yung pagtingin natin sa reconstruction, this is also to honor those who lost their lives, no? And the pain that these families are continue to endure and the future with that. We have to honor those who died. And most especially for those who survive, we need to help them live again, no? We have to bring life to the lives who survive. And this is what Walang Iwanan is all about. This is what volunteerism, bayanihan, and every Filipino, this is just the beginning. We are looking at a long-term relationship with everybody here, because relief is just maybe in the next 2, 3, or 4 months, at 6 months tops. After that, we need to begin to bring people back to normal life again, ano? So really, I really thank you in behalf of the victims that what you're trying to do over there, please continue to really bring this opportunity, this light to for the world to get to know the Filipino and what the Filipino truly is all about. Yun, sabi nga natin, walang iwanan.